Watch. Watch for the secret move. Did you see it? Did you see it?
No.
It was really subtle.
Get out of here!
To get to the airport. 30 days of magic
starts in Detroit.
Two things you may find interesting about Detroit: National Coney Islands, kind of a big deal. If you ever meet someone from Michigan, just ask them, oh, where do you live? And when you do it, put your right hand up. That's the international symbol. They'll point to their hand. Michigan's like a mitten. Meet someone from Michigan, that's in some way to kind of connect with them.
I just moved here from Michigan recently.
What part of Michigan? I'm from Michigan, man.
Where are you at?
I'm right here.
You're right there? I'm like right there.
Ann Arbor.
Ann Arbor? Yeah. I've been to Ann Arbor.
Detroit,
I fell asleep in a Starbucks.
Detroit Lions.
Ann Arbor. TJ.
Yes.
Check it out. So being here in LA, $5 really won't get you much, right? If you were magic, mm-hmm. and you could do anything you wanted, what would you do with a $1 bill?
Bag of Funyuns.
Dude, bag of Funyuns, $5. I know, you can't really buy
it. I want $100. If I was in Michigan, I might get a Faygo.
Some better made chips.
Some better made.
Check it out.
Here, really don't have better made chips. They don't.
What I maybe will do with this, look, if I take it.
Look at that shit.
Woo!
Look at that shit.
Oh, that blows my mind.
Look at that.
Literally, that blows my mind. Wow.
I can't go spend this.
Though.
Is it fake
though?
Check it out.
Is it fake? Hold it up to the light.
Put it in the light.
Hold it up to the light.
You see
what
my
is
man
that
right there?
You oh,
see it right
shit
there, right?
My man.
You
oh,
see
wow
it right there, right?
Whoa.
You see it right there?
Check it out. Have you ever been hypnotized before?
Nope.
No? Well, if I told you that you're hypnotized right now, because mm-hmm. look, if I take these ones,
mm-hmm.
Oh, damn, I like, wow.
There are ones the whole time. They never were 100s. Think I just carry around $500 in the street of LA? You were hypnotized.
I saw it too, I was hypnotized, damn.
I've never met this motherfucker in my life. These two motherfuckers came in saying that they met the most best magician outside.
Yeah,
I was a skeptic.
Yeah.
He's legit.
Hey, you put this on YouTube.
I
tell you, fuck Chris Angel. It's crazy.
Hey, this is a man. Right?
He's crazy. He no disrespect.
Detroit basketball.
Nothing tastes as good as being skinny feels. Well, they've never eaten here. What's up?
Yeah.
How you doing? So good to see you.
Oh, they are.
All right, search the world. For better burger,
okay.
Jesus
Christ.
Sleeping.
Good, dude. Good. I'm so happy for you, dude. And you inspired me to fucking make the move, and I've missed you in a gay way.
I wanted to have an interview with any of you guys about growing up with me and like magic and how stupid I was.
I wanna do it, dude. I wanna do it. You were so stupid.
I was just telling this girl. I was like, oh my god, you should have seen him. So fat, ugly, and stupid.
He was sitting on his front lawn doing the stealth pen by himself in a leather jacket when it was warm out. He was fat and he was ugly and I didn't want to be friends with him.
Ross, say any card in the deck.
King of Hearts.
Check it out.
That means it's party time, right?
Right.
Oh, what does Victor look like? When are we gonna see Victor? Well, here I am, right now. I'm the guy who's always behind the camera. So if any of you are wondering who Victor is, I'm Victor.
Victor is the gayest kid, the gayest kid to ever graduate from Ike. I don't even know how he graduated. Everyone's like, Victor's gay as fuck. Victor's a piece of shit. He's so stupid. Every time I see him, I just want, Victor's like, yeah.
So are you coming over?
Yeah, I'm coming over.
Evan and I met in 8th grade. Through the junior high years, like, he was still trying to, like, build his image. He was always trying to impress everyone with magic tricks. It was working out for him. It's just that he really still wasn't 100% confident in talking with girls or talking with the popular guys and just talking to a lot of people in general.
God, hey, show me somebody who shouldn't exist. Oh my God, you got that on the nose, dude. And then little do you know, later in life, this kid just blows your mind repeatedly over time and changes from being that kid to somebody that you can't even, you don't even want to connect the two. But the only fun part is that you can connect the two because it's almost a magic trick in itself. Nobody's been through more bullshit, more, he's heard more names than you've ever been called. And yet he can move out to LA because I wasn't the one believing in him. He was the one believing in him. And I eventually came along the way and joined the boat. It really has nothing to do with the people's opinion of you.
He was actually starting to lose a lot more weight because, like I said, in eighth grade, he was chubby. He was chubby. He started talking to more girls, and he started to talk to one girl in particular, in which he started dating that girl, and he dated that girl for quite a while.
Ross and Emming and...
I'm here, that's all that matters. I'm here.
And I was here.
Take it one. We got sign it. Oh, the ace of hearts. Your heart was broken?
By everyone who moved away without a kiss.
You ever have your heart broken?
Yeah.
I may have broken her heart, and it's kind of just in my nature. The old scorpion and the frog story. You're familiar with it?
Yeah.
Oh, well, you take me across. Oh, but you're going to sting me. No, I wouldn't do that. We'd both drown. Oh, okay, hop on. Scorpion stings the frog. They start drowning. But why? It's in my nature. Breaking hearts has been in my nature. So, your signature on the ace of hearts, Charlie Brown. What you're trying to do is break your heart. Tear it.
Break my heart. First world problems.
But usually that's not enough, right? It's not enough that they just tear it in half. They actually sometimes will tear it into quarters.
What, are you gonna make it go back to fucking normal?
And they're just like, so there you are with all your shattered pieces for everyone to see. It even has your name on it. Charlie Brown's broken heart. And normally something I can do is actually, I'll try to come in.
What's on your card, right?
He's
on the card. Okay, I was gonna say, like, oh shit.
I'll borrow someone's card.
He's just ripping everyone's cards up.
Yeah, right?
Right? Oh, yeah, I played my challenge. Dude, I actually went there one day.
Who's that?
Somebody, and sat there and talked to
him
about it.
I don't know. It was a vibe.
I don't fucking talk to
this bitch.
I don't know.
What are you trying to do? My girlfriend
upstairs. You always ask me
what I'm doing. I'm talking to you. What are you doing right now?
We're going to Detroit, films magic for Disturbed Reality, heading to American Coney Island with the use and the help of Twitter. We're meeting up with a fan from Disturbed Reality. I feel bad because he's been there since 1 o'clock and Victor took a wrong route to get here and now it's almost 2. How you feel about that, Victor?
I feel alright.
You should show me something. 2-5 of spades. Caught you there.
Why are you doing that?
Like I know what the hell I'm doing.
Right.
Alright. Take a card.
This one.
Okay, memorize it. When you got it, put it on top of a card. Which one should you put on top of?
You want me to tie it?
That one?
Yeah.
So you want me to slap, cut, or palm the card?
Palm.
Alright. So put your card there.
Yeah, but then I didn't do that.
And then...
Wow!
Nice.
Where do my
American Coney Island. I just showed some magic tricks. I know these people are about to eat their food, but I want to set something up, something special. So I'm going to do sealed with the kiss here because she's really interested in magic. So I have my two duplicates. People ask this all the time. How do I set up stuff like right in front of people? You just do it. Just do it kind of discreetly, whether you have to go off or I'll do it right in front of them. So. So there's my duplicate card. I'm done. That's all I need to do. Got my $5 on top. Got that on top. I'm ready to perform. And she doesn't even know the difference. So here, let's try something. Go ahead and take one that you want, one that calls out to you. Let the camera see it, let everyone see it. Just in case there are multiple aces of spades, it is a pretty common card. I want you to sign it. Think of this like a canvas. Your signature, make it very unique, one of a kind. If you were to see it again, you'd know that that's in fact yours. I want you to know something weird may happen, but I just want you to trust it and enjoy the experience of that. It might be a little weird. I'm just letting you know.
Oh my god. Oh my god, alright. I'm a very open-minded person, so go ahead.
Perfect.
Just do your thing.
So Marcella, I'm going to take your signed Ace of Spades, and I want you to just bite down on it. Take my chair down, five of diamonds. My name, Jarek 120.
Okay.
Five of diamonds, Jarek 120.
Oh my god. What are you doing? What are you doing? Oh my god. No, for real. What are you doing? No, stop. What's going on? Stop. What's going on? Oh my god, that is so weird. Stop.
Look at your card.
That's crazy. Oh my, that's so weird. What the hell?
Are you related to David Blaine?
Oh my god. Is it what?
Wow, that's great.
That's what you said.
Oh my god.
Damn, good trick. Yeah, good trick.
That's crazy.
Do you know me? Like, this is really weird. Like, I've never even met you before. Mind fucked right now. Just say that. Whoa, I'm shaking. That's so weird.
When you wake up, you can't put your hands apart.
What's going on? You're freaking me out. You're like, God, right now. I thought you were hypnotized. Was I? You were like,
no.
Was I hypnotized?
Was she?
Did you hypnotize
me? I didn't hypnotize you.
Are you sure?
I can hypnotize you.
Oh my god, no.
You did it to me last night.
I have to drive home.
Yeah, absolutely, Evan. Nice to meet you. So, so how are you doing?
Fine.
Doing well?
We met, right?
Yeah, we did meet. Alright, sleep. Relax completely. Relax deeper. Deeper and deeper. When I shake your hand, when I hold your hand, you will forget the English language. You will not be able to speak the English language. It will slur, mumble. It's a complete mystery. Gone from thought, absent from your mind. Perfect. How are you doing?
Good.
Doing well?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm Evan.
My name is John.
John, nice to meet you. Nice to meet you.
Vanessa.
Can you hypnotize this guy for me?
Ken, nice to meet you. Evan, what's your name?
You ask me before you fall.
It's Marcella, right?
Because I was scared for you.
What? Speak up. It's only when I shake your hand. Even though we are awake right now, you can still understand. It's only when you want to shake your hand. So if I let go, you can speak your language, you can speak your name easily, you can speak Troy, but only when I shake your hand, you won't be able to. Even though you're awake right now, you're still very suggestible. So if I let go right now, you'll be able to speak perfectly fine English. But only when I grab your hand, you'll forget. Your name's Marcella, right?
Yeah.
How you doing? Doing well. I'm doing really well. Everyone's happy to be here. Have you seen everyone doing well? You're going to become a lawyer, right?
Yeah.
Becoming a lawyer. So what's like? What's the most interesting thing you learned that you can share with us? What? What? Are you able to give me
me some legal advice?
Yes.
Okay, what's the most interesting thing?
I'm not a lawyer, yeah, obviously.
Right. Because you're a freshman, right?
Yeah.
Right, and how many more years do you have left and stuff? And put you a look to my hand. And I'm just going to tell you to sleep, and you will go down in that relaxing state when I snap my fingers. So, relax down.
I know Evan has told me numerous times ever since I've known him that for his two careers that he would either want to be a film editor or a professional wrestler. We would always come to Evan's house, and in his backyard, we would do backyard wrestling. We were posting up YouTube videos of it, and Evan was actually editing those videos. And that's how he started to build his video editing skills. Evan thought of it at first, he's like to Alex, how about you give me a Canadian destroyer? And Alex is like, that's a joke, right? And then Evan's like, no, I want to do it. And he's like, Evan, yeah, you know you're gonna die, right? He's just like, nope, I'm gonna do it. We're like, all right. We ran up to him, and then he wasn't saying, ow, my head. He's like,
you okay?
My knee.
We're like, your knee? this knee? Then he's like, you wouldn't believe it, but...
You all right? I landed directly on my neck.
No shit! You landed on your neck.
I couldn't tell.
Why are you recording still?
Because this is good stuff that he's dying. Does it hurt?
Do it again.
Kidding. Evan came into the house and showed his mom and dad. He's like, hey, mom, dad, you want to see me breaking my neck?
Okay, I'd like to welcome you all to Freeman High School for this very special assembly. Not that I'm biased or anything, but the guest speaker is my favorite son. He is my only son, but he's still my favorite son.
This was me in seventh grade. I was just getting into magic. I was made fun of a lot, picked on a lot, because I was the short, stocky, overweight, nerdy kid with acne, and who would do magic tricks? Trying to impress the popular kids. I never smoked, drank, or did drugs, and I still don't.
I think that Evan doesn't drink or smoke or any of that because he knows that he would love it. I never thought of it like he saw all sides to it. I thought of it like he's judging us, almost judging us for it. Maybe he thinks he's a little bit
better.
A little bit better, and it kind of puts him on top of the world. I never thought of it like maybe he understands that it's gonna be a bad addiction and that he, maybe he'd love it like everybody else does. It was amazing to me. Every time that we'd have our little periods where I wouldn't see him, maybe six months have gone by at a time where we didn't see each other. And I think he's got to have picked up drinking or smoking by now. Each time he gets a different perspective on it a little bit. He knows a little bit more about why he doesn't drink or smoke. And he sticks with it.
He didn't want anyone's approval to tell him what to do or how to act. Like, he would act in the way that he believed that he should.
It's just crazy to me because he's been through the stuff. He's been through the loops of love and life and normally it goes love, life, drugs, and you mix them all together and you get this jumbled, messed up, I'm an alcoholic and, smoke a pack a day and all that, and he doesn't. It's amazing to me.
And when I was in eighth grade, I was hated and ridiculed and picked on and made fun of to the ends of the world because the only things that I liked were magic, professional wrestling.
Mom lady, I'm card man. Mom lady's gonna take one. Anyone you want, free choice.
I just polished
my nails. Don't screw it up.
Check it out, show the camera.
Look at it, show the camera, look at it.
close to just wrist like that. Perfect. Two steps. Step one, take the Queen of Hearts, cover your hands like a sandwich. Don't let them get to it. Cover her hands like a sandwich. Cover their hands like a sandwich.
Oh my God, Allie, your hands are so cold.
Yeah, they're cold.
Different. They're always cold.
Okay, so step one, Queen of Hearts. Step two, take the Five of Diamonds. Next card down, watch. Mom lady.
Is that
with the Queen of Hearts. You feel anything?
I felt tickling.
Got it.
Bro!
Check in your hands.
Shit.
Shit.
Shit. Shit.
Yeah, I think Evan's doing the 30-day, this 30-day challenge hugely based on the reaction of the his followers and people that kind of look up to him and try to do kind of what he's doing. If I'm gonna expect people to do stuff to strangers and all that, I'm gonna need to be able to do it myself, obviously. How about for 30 days in a row with 30 different strangers, people that I've never met? Because it's not an easy task to perform magic trick to a stranger or hypnosis to a stranger, even one stranger. The thing about magic and hypnosis and things like that is that you're never gonna get good if you don't perform it to people. You could look in the mirror all you want and the invisible deck ain't gonna be any cooler. But if you do it to somebody who's never seen it before, it's amazing, you know. And it opens up a huge realm of what if. Oh, what if I screw up with this person? What if I screw up with that person? Well, it doesn't matter. You're still gonna go on the next day to a different stranger and try for not screwing up, you know, and hopefully you don't. But if you do, you hopefully learn from it and you don't do that mistake again. That's the great part.
What card you took, and I'd be able to figure out what card yours was, right? Because I'd spread through and there'd be one face down card.
Right.
Yes.
Right.
Do you want to change your mind? You want to pick a different card? I'll give you a chance to change your mind. You don't have to. You can stick with what you have.
I'm going
to
stick with what I got.
Okay. Yeah. I just wanted to give you the option.
Okay.
What was the card that you picked? What was it?
Five of Hearts.
The Five of Hearts. Is there a reason you picked the Five of Hearts?
No.
It didn't feel like I forced it on you or influenced you in any way, right?
Nope,
it felt like free choice.
No, yes.
Right. And you were holding onto this the whole time.
Right.
Shut up.
That's crazy. Fucking David Blaine. Man, seriously.
Derek 120.
That's crazy. Wow, that's good, man.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I appreciate that.
Yeah. That's wow, man. How long you been doing this?
8 years.
8 years. 8 years.
8 years, yeah.
Wow. Wow.
I mean, it's like anything.
It's like fighting a bear. I'm just I don't know.
It is kind of like finding a bear for 30 days in a row. She was crazy. All right, tomorrow.
It's not even
though.
The part about like fighting the bear. It's about finding the bears.
At least we're on the same page here. I mean, I didn't know what I would come up with, so.
See, you see pages. I see. You get what I'm saying?
He's just picturing bears fighting and shit.
Have me think of a card. Didn't tell him what card it was. Asked me if I wanted to change my mind. I said no. And ended up being, you know, I was thinking of the Five of Hearts or whatever. Never told him anything like that or whatever. He was like, now imagine I turn the card around or whatever, and of course I'd be able to pick that card out of the deck or whatever because it's, you know, it's whatever. It's faced the opposite way.
Okay.
Okay. So then he took the deck of cards out, spread the cards out, and there was one card flipped around. I took it, flipped it around, and it was a Five of Hearts.
Oh, nice. Nice.
I shit you not. This guy's crazy, man. This guy's crazy. You're crazy. You're crazy.
Go back. This is the moment. Tonight is the night. We'll fight till it's over. So we put our hands up like the ceiling can.
Going to a WWE event with Maurice Ouellette and her jewelry. Miz is gonna be there in Jericho and all those cool guys.
What's better than like professional wrestlers, magic, models, Johnny Depp singing?
You didn't say anything about models.
Yeah, Joanna Krupa, I have to interview her. She's voted the sexiest model in the world. so.
Is she brown?
No.
Not the sexiest
blonde.
Model in the world.
She's like, doing lights, hanging out. My mom is really not going to get too much.
$5 really not going to get you much, not going to do much for charity or anything, right? Tomorrow, Victor's having his big party, and I want people to come, but Ree and George are going to be there. If I go, and I see them, or if I just go in general, I'm going to regret it. But I also feel if I don't go and I go back to California, I'm going to regret it.
What's your one weakness, your only weakness, if you had to pick one single weakness? It ain't nothing to do with you. It's with her. She is your weakness. So I feel like it don't matter how many people you could go to this party and impress. Every single person at the party might be like, that kid is awesome. Like, he is doing something with his life. He just amazed me. But it doesn't matter, because the second that you see her, you're shattered. It doesn't matter what state she's in. It doesn't matter if she's drunk or sober. It doesn't matter how she looks at you. It doesn't matter what body language she gets from you. You are going to be broken when you see her.
Julie put it, she was just like, this could very well be the very last time you ever see her. And she's just like, you have a chance to either see her and potentially get closure, or avoid her and you don't have closure yet.
Ideally, you want to look back at the entire thing and be like, you know what, that hurt. That entire time period in my life hurt 10 years ago or whatever, 15 years ago. That was a painful love, but you know what? If I hadn't fell in love with her so hardcore, if I hadn't seen her and her boyfriend later on, and have that just nail me, I would have never, you know, ended up being a professional wrestler, or wherever you might end up being. Like, listen, like, I would never have gotten here if I didn't say, I need to, if I can't have her, you know, I'm gonna put everything that I can into myself. You needed to be heartbroken in order to become this extreme version of yourself. I don't want to see all that you've worked hard, so hard for, fall down because of the same thing that you worked so hard to be against.
Working out and doing like the YouTube channel and like moving out there and trying to be successful at it and all that stuff, I did it and used her like as motivation. And now that I've like gained a following and I have people looking up to me, it's almost become a responsibility. So slowly starting to transition like that. It's not about her, it's about me doing it for me.
She is gone. You need to look at yourself in the mirror and be like, you are it. You're the only one left, okay? She is fucking gone. If anybody's ever been in love and fallen out of it, they know exactly what it takes. And they're gonna be able to look at you and be like, the more pain and the further you've got from her, look at how much further you've got. You don't smoke cigarettes, you don't drink alcohol, because it would impair the fact that you have motivation and you want to get shit done. You want to actually accomplish your goals.
It's like if I didn't go, it's like, and you watched it
it's
back.
It's a once in a lifetime.
You watched it back. It's just like, that was a bad ending.
That would be a shitty ending.
Nice.
Okay, tell me when to stop.
Josh, you have to say stop.
Stop.
Magician!
Damn! Teach me how you did that.
I totally thought I'd fuck up.
You can see through the card.
Yep.
It's trickery.
It's trickery.
I mean, there's no markings on the back.
Oh. I mean, you just looked at it.
It's like a black card.
Yeah,
have you ever seen in Los Angeles, or they do it in Las Vegas and New York a lot. They'll have a cardboard box.
Yeah.
They try to mix around three cards. Yeah, three card money. You know it's just a scam, right?
Yeah.
Don't ever play it. They have people that are in on it, and as soon as, like, you'll watch them, people are winning money, people are losing money, and you, like, understand the game. Those people who are winning and losing are, like, in with the con artist to make you think, to make you build confidence.
Yeah.
And as soon as you throw down money, they change the way the game's played. Okay? I know people have lost $600 gambling with this game in 2 minutes. Don't ever play it. So when I see that happening, this is what I do back to those people to try to win some of their money, give them a taste of their own medicine. Go like this, like you'd hold a card. Now they use three cards, or the balls under the cups. I only use two cards. Makes it a little easier, all right? They always say, watch the heart, all right? So the Queen of Hearts. What card are you holding on to?
Queen of Hearts.
Queen of Hearts, perfect. You want to bet on it?
Sure.
How much? Say what I tell you, don't bet on it. Okay, double check just to make sure. Queen of Hearts, right?
Uh-huh.
That's hearts, Queen of Hearts, Queen of Diamonds, right? I'm gonna switch the cards twice, so fast that you won't even see it.
Okay?
Once, twice. So look back. You're the Queen of Hearts. See, what I did was I went like this and I stole it from underneath. Say the Queen of Hearts. Now hold on to it, not so it's impossible for me to take it, but still make it a little challenging. Yeah, perfect, just like that. So, I'm gonna do that same move, the same switch that I did twice. I showed you how to do it, I'm gonna do it again, okay? And then we're gonna bet on it.
Okay.
Hypothetically. This is why I do them again. Queen of Hearts, right there. Now without looking, because that was the real switch, without looking, what card would you bet is on top?
Queen of Hearts, I don't know.
You don't think I switched it?
No, I don't think you switched it. No, I don't think either. I don't see a switch.
So you would bet on it if you were in the streets?
Yeah.
Flip your hand over. Flip both cards.
What the heck? Oh my god! Wow!
I love it! I love it! I love it!
One day, maybe we'll figure it out.
How are we gonna figure it out? I mean, we've seen it. You're good, man. You're really good. You're excellent.
So I'm about to go out into the world, but there's a couple things. Whoa, that aren't sitting well with me. And one of them is this face. If you're gonna go out and perform magic to people, you have to feel confident in the way you look. Look good, feel good, smell good, do good. Who takes a quantum physics? Does anyone do any science related thing like that?
No.
You do? You're familiar with it? Come on over here. Someone's trying to explain to me where it's kind of like the idea. This is just how he explained it. The idea that if you put your hand against a wall and you align your atoms perfectly with the wall, you can start to move through it. The idea of like solids passing through a solid. And I was just like, obviously I don't believe that. Then he showed me this. He just, this was his kind of like disprovement or whatever. He basically said every solid object has a soft spot. Metal, steel, plastic, glass, bone, everything has a soft spot. And obviously I can't go on my index finger, I can't go on my thumb or else the rubber bands will snap off, top, bottom, middle. But if you search and you find the right soft spot. I'm gonna do that. Here, let's try that. Make two guns. Bang, bang, Cactus Jack. Make two guns. Go ahead. Pour them to each other. Give me a hook. Watch. Now bring your fingers in and put your thumbs over it. That's not going anywhere, right?
No, not going anywhere.
Same thing. Now that's in there. That's not an illusion. That's as fair as fair. That's as fair as fair can get, right?
It's on there.
It is in there. Obviously, can't go out the left hand. Can't go out your right hand. Can't go out the top, bottom, middle. Watch. Just find that soft spot.
Oh my god, dude. Well played.
There's kind of another one too that's like kind of interesting. It happens more fast, it's more dynamic. So here, go like this with your hand. Perfect, just like that. Watch what you can do. So if you know where to find that soft spot, bam, hit it with them. Oh dang! Gambling fools, but not your traditional gambling.
Kind of illegal at UCLA, so.
we got 52 cards. There's three of us. 30 bones on the table. High card takes it all.
All right, we're not gonna shove it. Make it went back.
No, you have to. Yeah, you have to cut.
Fuck!
Damn! Yeah. Well. Peace! Eight of spades wins it all! Now obviously if there was a hole in here, this would be impossible, right? Look. So check it out, not only of yourself, a nice little screen protector for your phone, but also a nifty little carrying case. That's why I put it in a nifty little screen protector first. Who has a $1 bill? Take it back off.
How did you get out that silver light?
Because what you're going to do is sign the back of it. That's see that? What's your name?
Aaron.
Aaron? Yeah. Alright, so Aaron's dollar bill. And what's your name?
Pia.
Pia? Pia's dollar bill. Alright. Here, I'll come up with here so everyone can see this.
Yeah!
The thing that's interesting about $1 bills is you guys were looking for all the watermark signs, right? You guys were looking on the $1 bill so you know how advanced these paper bills are, right? Mm-hmm. The interesting thing about $1 bills is they all have an insignia with a letter on it, L. And that L represents two things. It can be seen by both the beginning of the serial number, see how it starts with an L? So you know it's an L. And also the number 12. There's 12 rounds, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L. So that's how the insignia is represented. But here, go like this, like you'd pinch a dollar, pinch onto it. So look, if I take this, I can take the actual insignia, and look.
What?
Move it.
What?
Whoa.
I can't see.
Yeah, I can't see.
He moved it.
Whoa. Oh my god.
It's worth nothing.
He actually did it.
Is that actually?
Are you hypnotizing us again?
Stop. Turn it over.
Can you keep it like that?
Turn it over.
Are you sure?
I'm following it.
Still says,
is that legal?
Oh my god.
Are you hypnotizing us again?
You guys are having a birthday party and then we come and knock in.
Yeah, so they came up and like, hey, where you're from downstairs, and then like we just want to party, and I was like, I asked Alex if it was cool and it was cool, so yeah,
we're here. So we don't know these guys, so get out of your comfort zone, go, there's a party nearby, just go knock on the door, tell them who you are, ask them if you can do some badass magic tricks, steal the show, and then give some everlasting memories. So here's what I'm gonna do. It's a very, very special, just for the birthday girls.
And Josh.
I almost never,
and Josh. And Josh.
All of you, honestly. I almost never do this, because it's extremely painful. When I was growing up, I got made fun of fun of, bullied, picked on a lot for,
Justin Kim!
Okay, but look at you right now!
That's what I'm saying, dog.
Okay,
so I didn't have any friends, so one thing I would do to try to make friends was accept any dare. One day this kid comes into school, and he says, yo, Jarek, Evan, I saw this thing on TV last night. A guy took a piece of thread.
Who carries thread?
And he swallowed it. And he actually manipulated it and pulled it out of his nose and flossed with it. So he dared me to do the same thing. Now, I'll let you know right now, I couldn't get it to come out my nose. But
it's gonna be out of one of their noses.
Everyone cover your bubble.
No, it's gonna make it come out of someone else's nose.
It does not mean. You need silence.
It's gonna come out of
your eyes. Turn up!
Hey guys, shut up.
Turn up.
It's Alex! Alex! No kidding.
I'm so confused right now. I'm pretty sure it's not illegal.
Oh my God!
Is he the strongest? He's stronger than me, right?
Of course.
But can he do this? But he can't do that. Crush a can? Pretty tough, right? Who's the Lex Luthor isn't your opponent though? But if I were Lex Luthor, I'd be a pretty big threat to you, right? He's got the mental ability. So what? That's what I'm gonna do. Should itself. Got that mental ability, but watch. Could also. That's that. Is that Coke? Drink it.
Pretty good. Pretty nice.
Lex Luthor. Let's compare muscles. I don't know if I can become a professional wrestler just by working out and going through the natural thing. So my plan is to become a famous magician or a famous hypnotist, right? Because I have learned how to hypnotize people legitimately. At one point, go to WWE and be like, hey, you should use me for a spot or we should collaborate somehow. Let me come be a special guest host or whatever. And then we'll collaborate to where I can take a bump. Then I'll transition to becoming a professional wrestler that way. This is where my big idea comes in. Get a big time main event match for the championship. I'm scheduled to lose, right? Main event match. Backstage before the show, me and my opponent are talking over, the champion and I are talking over. I hypnotize him.
Okay.
Legitimately. And I basically tell him, when the bell rings, when you hear this noise, and I'll ring the bell, you'll lay down in the ring. And I'll basically hypnotize him to get pinned, to lose to me. And then we'll go out on national TV, scheduled for a 20-minute match. Bell rings, goes in trance, down. I'm the big-time face, he's a big-time heel. Look at the camera, hold the title up, heel turn, and now I can use magic for bad. And then it'll make huge controversy. It's just like, this guy legitimately hypnotized this guy into losing a championship on paid TV, and Vince McMahon didn't know it was gonna happen.
Yeah, well, it takes a special kind of jerk to do that.
I could go to the ref before and be like, here's the spot. Here's the spot in the beginning. You're gonna count to three, and it's gonna be like a Dusty Rhodes finish. And then I'll just walk out with the belt. Now I'll get fired the next day, but it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
Made national news and I held the title.
Well, keep it. You want it. It's yours.
The belt. You can wear it in jail.
You guys know what I wanted to be when I was growing up? Magician, a Superman, a lawyer. I wanted to be a professional wrestler. In my life, in this life, in my life, there's nothing I love more than professional wrestling. I admire guys like The Rock, Stone Cold Steve Austin, Chris Jericho, The Undertaker, Shawn Michaels, all those guys. I wanted to be like them. I wanted to wrestle them. And my ninth grade guidance counselor thought I was crazy and delusional for telling her I wanted to be a professional wrestler when I grew up.
I think I found hell. I think I found something. I think I found something in my TV screen. I think I found out that I have nothing. That I have nothing in this place for me. I watched it all in my head. Perfect sense. Don't take me from my bed. Leave everything that is worth a single cent and just take me instead. I saw as I fell asleep. Had me on both my knees. Praying to whatever is in heaven. Please send me a felon. Don't let the police know anything.
Anything. What's that?
Huh?
What's that? That coin behind your ear.
I think I can tell. I think I can tell them. Tell them they were made for me. I'm thinking they'll know. Know it already. I'm thinking they'll know just about everything. I bet they planned it all out like the shows. Went everywhere I go. Walked in the store right behind me. Stood in line right beside me and followed me to my home. I'm sure they figured it out early on that I would never run, that they could shoot, but that's no fun, 'cause then they're killing the stolen son. Oh, anything, anything, don't tell them anything,
deepest attraction a person can have for you, the deepest
level of traction that anyone can ever have for you is when you bring out the best in them. When you find the thing that makes your life worthwhile, the thing that you can constantly and continually get better at and keep evolving and learning, that's the thing that you're supposed to do. Gimmick magician. I love wrestling. I worked my ass off for the past year to get in the shape that I'm in. And the last thing I ever want is for someone to not take me seriously in this ring, because this is like the only thing that makes my life worthwhile. It's the only thing I love to do. And 4 hours before we drove out here from Michigan, I got a call from Drew that said, the weekend's open if you want to drive down. So I lost 2 days worth of pay. I went in at the last minute on the road to Massachusetts so I could be here to do the thing I want. And I told my boss, I have to do this because this is the thing that makes my life worthwhile. Because this is the greatest thing I could plan it to be. Not magic. Wrestling is my number one priority. Magic is just my hook. So, with that being said too, my goal in wrestling, I won't be happy, I won't be satisfied until I get a match with Chris Dickinson. That's my number one goal right now. Whoa. I got in the best shape of my life. And Chris Dickinson was an inspiration to me, and this is the only place that I know Chris Dickinson will hear this. Really, I will not be happy, I will not be fulfilled in this sport until I get a match with Chris Dickinson. So, I'm laying it out there, Chris, so I want to hear it. I want to hear your answer. It's not a shoot, it's no disrespect. I just won't be fulfilled in this business if I don't get to wrestle you once.
Book it, Drew!
Is not that we're inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. It is our light, not our darkness, that most frightens us. We ask ourselves, who am I to be brilliant, talented, rich, famous, gorgeous? Actually, who are you not to be? Your playing small does not serve the world. As we let our own light shine, we are consciously giving people permission to do the same. We are liberated from our own fear, our presence automatically liberates others. With that said, be a superstar. Take 100% responsibility, create value for others without worry for what you may get back in return. Do not give up, and always rise above.
Flying back to LA in about 3 hours or so. We're gonna try something a little special. Normally tricks are like pick a card, any card, and just like some bullshit like that, you know. Well, we don't necessarily want to do that. We're gonna try something a little different. Yeah, like I said, you need two free hands. We'll just use. We only gonna use two cards. We'll use the six diamonds.
Give me a card.
I'm gonna turn into a bitch.
Yeah, you're fine. Six diamonds, four diamonds. So yeah, not Chicago, LA. Michigan born and raised. So here's what we're gonna do. What I'll do is we'll give you the six of diamonds. Hold on to it. Put your sandwich the card just like that. Don't anything to do it. Put your hand over his hand. Put your hand over his hand just like that. Watch. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. Watch. I'll take the four diamonds. You got the six diamonds. Watch. What's gonna happen is gonna be pretty interesting. Watch. 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 Just watch the four. I'll do it like over here.
Hey, look
at this little touch. Oh, so now the six of diamonds wants to switch.
Hey, stop looking at my elephant.
Look. Look.
What the fuck?
What the fuck?
Hey, my nigga, you good, cuz? My nigga, that card has a flipping.
Six of diamonds. What's that card you got there?
The card is a shaded.
I drew that, man. No way, man.
Play with the card!
No way.
It's magic from LA, the Illuminati.
It was just going like this.
I want you to fold your $5 bill came out of your pocket, right? Fold your $5 bill in half. But fold it the hot dog way, the long way.
We're in a recession, man.
Hot dog, nigga.
Coney Island, American, Lafayette. American or Lafayette?
American!
Oh, American! Lafayette! Alright, here, check this out. Feed it through here, the bottom of this. Okay, and fold it down in half, and take that paperclip and paperclip the bottom of the bill together. So that's not going anywhere, right? Dollar bill, rubber bands that we use for you, check it out. Think of this. Think of this like a stairway.
Bands will make your dance.
Okay? A stairway. I'm gonna try to get it to go up one step at a time.
This is not possible.
Okay?
So not possible.
I'm gonna try and do this. Watch.
Hey, you guys wanna see something very impressive?
This is so impressive.
What?
That's one. That's one, but watch. Now I have to get to jump the next band. It's a little more difficult. But watch. And you can see it from the back. Watch.
Hey, do you smoke weed?
Oh, this. It'd be funny if I did that. It'd be kind of, no, but it's cheating.
You should. Watch. You'd be a lot better.
Hey, Sam. Here, try out. Just hold on to it. Just pinch it.
Hey, Gangnam Style.
Just like that. Just like that. Watch.
Oh, fuck. Gangnam Style.
How?
You know how to his bank account set up?
When you do it 3 million times, you're going to figure it out.
Right? I got it.
Just keep it a secret.
You just figure shit out.
Can I ask you a question?
You're good, man.
You'll be on
room.
Awesome. What's your YouTube channel?
How to.
Give me a card.
How to. Disturb reality.
Alright, give me one.
How to smoke some weed.
Pretty gay.
How to fucking trick idiots on the street.
I just moved to Los Angeles recently, and what I liked about Michigan so much is $5 could actually get you somewhere. It could actually. Buy you like something. Yeah, go to the Kickstarter Club. Buy you Faygo. Better made. Doesn't matter what it was.
But
like dollars. Yeah, it was. It's simple here. And back there, they don't have. He's dipping out. Back there, it was pretty. Back there was pretty simple.
Thank you, brother.
All right, man. Have a good night. I'll see you.
Okay, let me see.
I was joking, man.
I know, dog. Right. I know. So, because I moved out to LA, I had to try to figure out a way to make something out of very little, something out of nothing. So what? Thankfully, I've learned to do.
He's gonna make it a $5 bill.
No way. Whoa.
He's gonna make it to $10.
What the fuck?
Hey man, I'll fuck you work for me.
Hey, bro, hey, bands will make your dance. Like,
I got 10, man. 300.
I'm throwing the IRS on your ass, bro.
No way, man. Dude, get him back to singles, man.
Well, why would I want to do that? I'm going to.
Hey, I want to do that, bro. Now you going to kick it.
Hey, teach me that one, man.
I teach that one on the channel.
Is there a magician?
Is
there a magician? A magician?
Thank you.
Is there a magician here?
You had 5 singles, okay? 5 singles, and you changed it into $500. That's crazy.
He's telling her to get hit.
I swear to God, I could not believe it. $500. He had $5 and he changed it into $500. I don't know how you did it. He just changed it like that. That's crazy. I witnessed it. I swear to God, I could not believe that shit.
That's YouTuber.
Oh my God, man.
Dude, have a good time.
Oh my God. I have nothing else. I swear to God, I have no other tricks. I can't do shit. That's craziness. This is crazy. This is crazy. I don't know.
I'm
That's better.